Even before a female baby is born, she is worried about preparing for her future generation. Here is the schematic diagram of her ovary, and inside the ovary there are millions of primordial germ cells. These primordial germ cells, they first form oogonia and ultimately form primary oocyte, which is well equipped and ready to undergo the process of meiosis. Before it can start the process of meiosis, a layer of cells surround it. It protects it from the immune system, because as a result of meiosis, the daughter cells that will be formed will have different genetic makeup because of crossing overs. And this follicular cells, along with this primary oocyte, this structure as a whole is called primordial follicle. So this primary oocyte, it starts the process of meiosis, right? And with the prophase 1, ultimately it reaches up to the crossing over, and it reaches up to which phase? Up to diplotene phase, and it is then arrested in diplotene phase. It does not complete the process of meiosis, and this resting diplotene phase is called dictyotene phase. It remains arrested till the start of puberty. Also, the nucleus of this primary oocyte, it gets filled with water and it swells up, and this protects it from the harmful substances, and it is now called germinal vesicle. Then follicular cells, it releases certain factors that are called oocyte maturation inhibitor that keep this oocyte arrested in meiosis 1. This process, it reminds me of Asian mothers who start preparing the food before a guest has to come to their home, and they make the food half done. And when the guest arrives, they complete the cooking process. And that's what ovary is doing. Before the baby is born, ovary starts the process of oogenesis. So this is this young teenage girl just going to start puberty, and her ovary consists of lots of primordial follicles. And primordial follicles, they consist of oocytes, primary oocytes surrounded by a layer of follicular cell. So follicular cell grow, and they form primary follicle along with a glycoprotein coat that is formed, zona pellucida. It cannot replicate or proliferate. It needs order from FSH and LH. And FSH and LH, they are released by the orders of GnRH. So these gonadotrophs, FSH and LH, they cause the proliferation of these cells, follicular cells, and it has now become multilayered. So it is primary follicle, that is multilaminar. Then what happens, that interstitial cells around it to form two layers or coverings, that is theca interna, that is more cellular, and theca externa, that is more vascular and less cellular. Theca cells under the order of LH synthesize testosterone, which is picked up by these follicular cells to form estrogen. Now, because it is producing estrogen, so estrogen granules form in these follicular cells, and now these follicular cells at this stage with these granules, they are called granulosa cells. Estrogen has different functions. One of the functions is that it causes priming of LH receptors on these granulosa cells. Now these granulosa cells can also listen to order of LH and further growth, and this primary follicle has now lots of layers of granulosa cells. Then these follicular cells, they secrete pockets of follicular fluid, and they coalesce to form antrum. And now this primary follicle is converted into secondary follicle. In the mid of cycle, there will be LH surge, right? And due to LH surge, follicular cells will, or granulosa cell will listen to orders of this LH hormone to release the arrest, and there will be resumption of meiosis 1, right? They will complete the meiosis 1, and it will now form secondary oocyte that is now arrested in metaphase 2, right? And along with that, polar body will be formed, and now it is fully mature follicle. Now it is called Graafian follicle, or some people like to call it tertiary follicle. Now it will be released into uterine tube by the process of ovulation, and now it is waiting for the sperm to come, and if the sperm comes, it will fertilize it, and before that, before fertilization, it will complete the meiosis 2, right? Otherwise it may die out, and it is converted into corpus luteum.